Hi guys, I'm Michael Buchwalder, and today you join me at Preston Lakes in Birmingham, where we're doing something a bit different today as our normal filming. We're not going to show you how to catch all the fish and how to feed the peg and that. We're going to show you some of the techniques that I use to try and fish at extreme range. A lot of the matches I've been fishing for the past couple of months have been places like Boddington Lakes, where you've got to chuck a long, long way. The cast's got to land really, really well. If it lands wrong, your bait's not presented properly. Bearing in mind, you're only having like maximum, really, if you're on a flyer, 6-7 casts in 5 hours. Everything's got to be perfect. So we're going to look today to try and fish well over 100 metres, probably up to 120 metres. We're at Preston on peg 93. It's not the best peg in that, but it gives me opportunity to fish long and maybe get a few skimmers and get my technique in by not sitting there for 5 or 6 bites. But I can see where my feeder's landing. I've got a marker on a far bank, so I can see where it's landing perfectly. I'm just about getting the distance right. I've got a distance master today, 4 meters, and with a couple of intensity, 720. Now this might make a few of this smile. I'm fishing for big carp, but I've got 4 pound sinking mono on with a 12 pound shock leader. The sinking mono being in 4 pound, it's almost like equivalent to fishing a braid. It's really thin. It's gonna flow through the eyes really quickly. And obviously I need a shock leader to cast a long way. I'm going to start off by using a 45 gram Banjo XR, obviously with a mold. I like it in 45 gram as opposed to 60, because I just think I get a little bit of a less splash. The way I fish and the way I cast, everything's got to be to go in nice and smoothly. So I'm going to show you some of the techniques now that I used to try and fish at extreme range and push the rod to its absolute limit. We're all set up now. I've clipped my rod up, clipped up at 105 metres in the sticks. We'll go through that in a little while and show you exactly how I clip up on the sticks so it alleviates any tangles and bits and pieces. Got my feeder now, gonna load my feeder. We'll show you how to load the feeder correctly, removing any excess from the feeder, trying to make it as aerodynamic as possible. Then we're gonna go through the process of making the long cast. So, gonna use a mold, makes it nice and easy for us. Get it in there, compress it in. Lay your line in, try not to trap your line. Obviously, you don't want to kink any line. You're going to hook a 10-pound carp. The last thing you want to do is lose it through bad angling. So we can press down now. We're going to remove any excess pellets off the side of the feeder just to make it as nice and as aerodynamic as possible. We're going to compress it down a bit because we're looking 15, 20, 40-minute cast. So it needs to be nice and smooth, nice and compact in. Want it to get to the bottom and fish properly, not break up on the surface. So when trying to fish a long way, I can't see the point of sitting down to cast. You're not using your full core, so you're not projecting the rod, and you're not doing anything right. So always stand up. Your stance is really important fishing. You don't want to be slipping and falling in. So literally, I'm right-handed, so I'm always going to cast on my right side. So my left foot comes forward, gives me a blocking area where I'm not going to fall forward or anything like that, and gives me lots of leverage to power off. So a lot of people I see, I reel in real tight to the rod, like a 2.5-3 foot drop like that. I don't. When casting a long way, I like to have a drop about 3-4 foot. 4 foot's perfect for me. And the biggest thing for me is casting off your finger. Always cast like this. I know a lot of the guys cast with a finger on a spool. What you're doing is you're losing a lot of the power from your hand. Your hand holds an awful lot of power. That's where the grip comes from. So I can grip the rod properly like that now with my index finger holding the line. Not going to cut through. It's a 12 pound carp line. It's never going to break your finger. So that's my grip there. My other rod's coming to here. But as you'll see in my cast, I change my grip halfway through the cast. So I'll do the cast in slow motion to start with. We're swinging forward. We're trying to compress the rod. It's a 100 gram rod. It's a big rod. So it needs to compress to be able to fire it out. The blank's never going to shatter on a cast like this unless you have a massive mishap and crack over the tip. But if you get your technique right, compress the rod, it's going to go a long way. So I'm swinging forward a couple of times. I'm then going to come back over my shoulder. And as I come back, I'm then going to grab the butt of the rod like this. And all the force comes from this hand here. This hand here, I keep on a straight arm. all the force comes here, and the power rod comes through the hand there. So you're pulling the rod through yourself like this and under there. And as you get to the here, the cast, you let go at about 11 o'clock. If you let go any lower, the cast goes too low. You can't get distance unless you get a height. So the higher you cast and the velocity going forward obviously increases your cast. So you can't cast 30 feet off the ground. You need to be casting 70, 80, 90, 100 foot up in the air. The feeder travels, line comes off the reel, so you've got a big spool, and you hit your clip. So you want to be hitting your clip 10, 15 foot in the air, holding a rod and feathering the feeder down to the surface. So it goes in with as little as plop as possible, basically. You don't want to smash all your pellets off. So I've got the bail arm off now. I'll go through my proper cast now, is how I'd do it if I was fishing a match. And hopefully we don't. It all goes perfectly and shows you what I mean. So we go forward a couple of times, we go back one motion, and straight up, there we are. There you go. Hit the clip, 105 meters, perfect. 10 foot off the air. Now, we've got a lot of line out there now. So what we don't want to do is start reeling. Most waters, you've got 100 meters line out. There's going to be a bit of tow, a bit of ripple. So it's a case of literally, we're going to move the rod around the rod dress. We're going to walk slowly with it, keeping the tip not moving at all. What I don't want to do is put a big bow in the tip and bend it around. So we're going to go around really, really, really slow. Just to pull any slack line out. The feeder's in the bottom now. So what we don't want to do is move it. So you take it around to here, rod in the rest, drop it down. We've not bent the tip one little bit. We're going to leave the tip under the water now for about 5 minutes, just to let that line, it's called sinking mono for a reason. Let the line sink down with the tow. I don't mind if there's a massive tow in there because I'm not looking for liners. I'm looking for a tip that pulls right round with a great big carp on the end. So that's the process now. I'll give it a couple of minutes. I'll lift the tip up just so I can see it, but just under the water. That is the process how I make a big cast. It's really, really, really important though, is that left hand is where all the power is generated. And so many guys don't get it wrong. What other thing I see guys doing is, we'll reel it now, show you. Might take a few seconds to reel in because we're quite a long way out, but it's really worth noting this. It's kind of the do's and don'ts of casting a long way. If you get it wrong, you break your line and you're resetting up the bank. And not all guys have got two or three feed rods they can set up fish a long way. Getting there. Let's take a while to reel in 100 meters. It's coming. We'll get there. One of the things I see guys doing is this. I've seen quite a few crack offs. They sit like this. They're waiting. I don't know what they're waiting for. And they go for a big crack like this with a small drop. The problem with that is you're not fishing a carp rod. Carp rod's got massive big eyes at the tip. A lot of the carp guys that fish distance fishing have got great big tips on the end of their rod. So they go for it like that. They can. They've got 3 or 4 ounce carp lead and their tip eyes probably the same diameter as your third eye up on this distance master. So it's a lot more in their favour. We've got bigger reels than we have. They're fishing 14,000 size reels. So it's all in their favour. We have to be a bit more compressing the rod. The only way we can compress a rod is by going forward, backwards and in one big motion. So for me, that's the only way to fish 100 metres plus. Just reeled in from doing one of my longest casts then, so I'm going to put it on the sticks now and show you how I do it. I put my hook into the foam at the bottom there, protects the hook with a method feeder with an XR banjo in front of it. I'm not going to rush it because it's going to be a long way. So we're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What I do is, if we're on a narrow towpath and there's people coming past, I always do it in tens. That way, if you have to move and come back somewhere, let someone pass, you're at a nice number you're not going to forget, aren't you? It's so simple. I see some people trying to stop at like 12 or 13, let people pass, have to redo it. So we're at 10 at the moment. So we go 11, 20 reps now, 2 meters apart. We're at 40 meters now. Notice the way I'm doing it, I've got it on anti-reverse is off, so the reel spins backwards, but I'm controlling it all the time with my right hand. Just going slowly. There's no need to go, get a massive spin up. 21. So 30. This is where most of our time was spent fishing. I reckon we're going to end up at about 60 wraps. So 21. Oh, nearly. 48, 49, 50. See there, I started to rush there and it nearly went wrong. So I'm at 50 wraps over 100 meters now. It's an awful lot of line out there. So what I don't want to do is mess this bit up here and have 100 meters of line in a bird's nest. So over 50. 56, what's that? 56, nearly 57, a foot short of 57. So 113 meters that one was. So it's a fairly big cast. Now when I come to reel this bit off here, it's really important to pull it up one. So I just basically stand back a bit. What I do is I bring the rod right across the side. So one, bringing it right over, just nice and slowly. But bring your rod right across there to pop it off the end of the spike. What you don't want to do is lift up and pull, like tangle it and pull up a load of line off at the same time. So just going real steady again. You got a bit excited then. It's just so important a tool for your feed fishing nowadays, a distance measuring sticks. How are we ever used to count reel turns and stuff? I don't know. We just haven't got time to do it anymore. Now we have like 5 or 6 rods set up. We know that everyone is basically millimeter perfect doing this. So without a doubt, an ultimate weapon. Getting now towards the end. So just slow down again now. Simple as that. Anti-reverse. Seal off, pick it, hook out. Simple but effective. Just going to quickly recap on what I've told you about the long chucking on the feeder. Rod, nice and powerful, 4 meters or more. Reel, 4 pound line, 12 pound shock leader. And really, to get these sort of distances, you need to be going down. I mean, when I first started doing it, I was going to my local field and just sitting there chucking to the end of the field basically. There's no one around half the time, so just putting a straight lead on, ounce and a half lead, just chucking it down. Problem is, this time of year, sticks in the mud, so it's good exercise having to walk down to the field to retrieve it out of the mud, but it gets you chucking that distance. It's all about practice. You can't do it unless you're going week in, week out, and just, it doesn't take 20 minutes, take a rod down the field, 20 minutes, chuck out. It's simple as that. Hopefully you've picked up a few things on chucking a long way. I'm going to have one more chuck now, make sure I haven't forgotten anything.